Urban Accelerator X is an entrepreneur support organization that is run by people of color for people of color. Here to tell us more about their company is Chief Marketing Officer Lolo Smith. Lolo, thank you so much for coming on the interview today.
Hi there. I meant to tell you, I love the color of your hair.
Oh, I thank you so much. I really like all the bright colors. You're so organized. Your background looks so nice.
Oh yeah, this is some of our branding colors, so you know.
Ah, clever. So I figured I would just go ahead and ask you a couple questions and we can get started.
Yes, really excited.
All right. So tell me more about Urban Accelerator X, what your company is and what you do.
Okay. So Urban Accelerator X, so we actually go by the U because we feel like it's really simple. But we are an entrepreneur support organization. And so we focus on supporting Black and Brown businesses. And not only that, but we take it a step further and we want to make sure that we're focusing on lifestyle businesses or businesses that are often, you know, overlooked. And with the Midwest becoming like the new quote unquote Silicon Valley, there's so many different businesses out here that are ran by minorities or people of color that just are not in that tech field or that bio field that most entrepreneur support organizations are looking for, most accelerators are tapping into. And so we want to make sure that we're offering those resources to like the mom and pop shops, you know, those businesses that really make the neighborhood, those businesses that really create the culture for the cities. But then they often are the first ones to go out of business. So that's kind of a little bit about us. I mean, you know, we can get a little bit more detailed about how we do that. But we do focus on the resources, the education, the networking, and then also helping provide access to funding as well.
So when was the U founded?
So we actually, I'm really excited because, so we have made it over a year. So it's actually been about a year and a half. We were founded in 2019. And then we actually launched last year in January. So we did kind of like a build out. We did some soft launches, a few different workshops and boot camps before we actually launched. And then last year we launched and then we experienced COVID.
I was just going to ask, you know, you started in 2020. Did that put some hangups in when you started the business, or how did that look?
So to be transparent, it did. And which is something that I like to talk about, because hearing the fact that, like, you know, we are an entrepreneur support organization, and then the fact that we were like, hey, we might possibly have to close, but we were able to be able to pivot. And so relying on some of the other skills that we had, we actually were able to expand our resources, which is something I do want to talk about, like some of the things that we offer, but it was great. So it wasn't great at first because we're like, how do we do this? A lot of our services at the time was like education-based. So that's people coming in, taking courses, getting that one-on-one interaction. And so when COVID happened, it really put us like in a situation where we had to reevaluate, how do we take the same experience and we host it virtually? And then also continue to keep that engagement and continue to offer that same level of experience for people who are trying to get help. So yeah, it was kind of weird, but we were able to make it through. And actually, it was a blessing in disguise now that I look at it, because we're doing so much better than we would have ever thought we would be able to do after COVID. So yeah.
Well then, I was gonna ask next. So you're having that ability to be in person a little bit taken away, especially with COVID coming into play. So then would you say that some more opportunities opened up with the fact that you can meet digitally? What are your thoughts on that, meeting digitally versus in person?
Yeah, so actually I think it'd probably be good for me to just kind of tell you about the divisions that we have in our actual business model. And so one of the things that developed from going to this more virtual, or we were being forced to be virtual, was that we developed what is called the Lab Studio. So that is our division where we help businesses pivot as well. And we offer streaming services. We host people's engagement, because it's one thing to just do a Zoom. But then it's another thing to create an experience, create some type of engagement. And so that was one of the things that we had soft skills in. You know, we've my business partner, he's really great with tech and fiber. It's like our inside joke. But he's really great with that. And then I'm really a creative. And then our other business partner, she's really good at facilitating and creating those relationships. And so with that whole dynamic, we were able to create a whole new business model out of that. And we realized that, especially in our target market, a lot of the businesses were suffering severely because they weren't open. You know, a lot of people, either they have like an actual shop, or, you know, they're doing some type of in-person service or something like that. And so when we were able to pivot, we were able to also help other businesses pivot and do it in an affordable way. Like, hey, have you thought about being able to do this virtually? Have you thought about setting up an online shop? And so then that's where we came in, and we came up with the whole lab studio, like, just come to us and we'll be able to help you with your virtual services. So that was like the first, that's like the first piece of Urban Accelerator X. And then we have what we call the Lab University. And so that's where we house all of our education-based services. And so we do workshops. We have an annual accelerator. We actually just had a mini winter accelerator. And it's just a lot. We do like boot camps, just so many different things where we offer education to businesses. And then the last part, which is one of my favorites, but the last part of our business is called Theory University. And so Theory University, we partner with entrepreneur support organizations. And then also, like, we've done some things for the city, the county, on a government level. And so they contract us to be able to create culturally competent, not only curriculum, but experiences. And so what we notice about our actual demographic and then our target market is that it's not that there necessarily is a lack of resources, it's a lack of access to resources. And people sometimes feel intimidated because there's this gap of knowledge. And so we put ourselves, like, we're going to be right here in the middle. So these people who have these great ideas, or maybe have these mom and pop shops, but they don't really have people in their family, their network, who have a business mindset, so they're kind of winging it, mm-hmm. and they're on a higher scale to maybe be able to fail. Well, we create an environment that's safe for them to come into, and we help other people create that environment. And then we allow them to feel safe and to get the resources that they need, or get the connection that they need, versus going somewhere. It's like, if you wanted to go to school, I mean, sometimes you're not going to think, like, the first place I'm going to go is Harvard, you know? So it's kind of like, we're like the community college of of the university war, real.
So some keywords that are coming out to me is this collaboration. You know, you have your business partners. You mentioned each of you has different skills that bring very many different resources to the table. And then you also mentioned that what really stood out to me is that there are resources, but the availability isn't necessarily there. I thought that was very powerful to point out. Do you have any thoughts on kind of that privilege disparity of who has access to what? Do you want to embellish a little bit more on that if you are comfortable?
Yeah, for sure. And that's one of the things that I like about us being here at the U and actually having the partners that I have, because we're not afraid to have those conversations about, hey, there is a huge gap. There's a disparity. There is privilege when it comes to this particular thing. And so I do believe that there is just a historical disparity when it comes to access. And it has a lot to do with so many different things, where it can be someone, especially in a Black and Brown community, someone doesn't have a lot of people in their family who has had a successful business, or who is a millionaire, who can give you a loan, who has access to funding, who knows someone who has funding. And it's just because historically they have been set back, you know, we have been set back. And my ancestors didn't have the same privileges or the same access to things. And so when we look at that and we have that conversation of like, oh, it's not just because this group of people, like, they're not smart or they're lazy or whatever, it has nothing to do with that. It's really about just the access to it. And it could be as simple as language, for example. And that's something that we don't really see people talk about. But I've seen a lot of times where someone's just intimidated because they don't know business language. They might not know what MVP means. And so now, you know, the whole experience is turned off to them, because you might go to more of a advanced accelerator and they're speaking in business terms because everybody else is already at that level. And you're kind of sitting there like, okay, how do I figure out this call structure? You know, I mean, it's a huge, and it's something that's near and dear to our hearts, because I've been in that situation before. I didn't go to school for business. And so I wanted to start a business, but a lot of it was trial and error. And there wasn't a lot of people in my family who could give me this information. And I have felt intimidated going into classes. I have felt intimidated being a part of workshops. I have felt like, what the heck is that? The difference is, every time I heard something I didn't know, I would hurry up and Google it. But sometimes people are even afraid to be able to do that. So if we create this environment where we meet people where they are, then that will help us create more successful businesses, when in all actuality helps our economy as a whole. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, it's like a whole deep thesis, but.
Well, absolutely. That jargon can be so deterring. Like, it can be a deterrent for people who do want to start a business, who have these great goals and have these wonderful ideas that contribute so much to the community. So it's very important that Urban, the U, is providing those opportunities for people to come and learn. So like you said, you host these workshops, you host these education workshops and such. And so it's really great to get to learn more about that and about your company. So yeah. And are you hosting any events right now? You said you had a mini winter project going on. Do you want to tell me a little bit more about that?
Yeah, so we had a mini winter accelerator, and that it ended in January. We were going to have a pitch competition the same week as inauguration. And it was really intense that week. So we decided to push it back to the end of February. So we actually have that coming up pretty soon. And we're going to host it virtually. And we're going to invite some of the entrepreneur support organizations who are out in the area, so that people, when they graduate from our program, they can go ahead and fit right into a more accelerated program for them. We also have coming up, actually in 2 weeks, we're going to be launching what is called our Urban Launch School. And so it's an online program that the individuals, you don't have to be just Black and Brown, okay? So, but usually the target for that is you're in the early stages of launch. So maybe you have an idea and you haven't really fleshed it out, or you've launched, but it's still pretty wonky. And so you take this online course and it walks you through all of the steps from ideation all the way to launch, so that you make sure that you're covering your bases. Some of the things that we have coming up more so in quarter one or towards the end of quarter one will be that we're creating a full online lab university where people can take workshops. It looks like an actual school, so you'll be able to register for different series of classes. And then the last thing is we're creating is something called Urban Society, And so that's just a networking society that you're able to meet other entrepreneurs, but you also are able to get a lot of resources that it may cost a lot. So say, for example, you want to get some legal advice. You know, it might cost you a lot if you're a startup, or it might seem really extraneous, but you need that. And so we have a community where you'll be able to get those resources, and you just pay like a small monthly fee. So those are the things that we really have, like, that's immediate, that's coming up, that I would think of that's really, really beneficial for our audience.
Mm-hmm. So then that pitch competition that's coming up in February, where can people find more information about that? Your website, or is there a Facebook page?
Yeah. So the pitch competition is not actually going to be like live for everyone. So it's pretty much invite only. So that's because this is the first time that we've done it in this setting. We wanted to make sure that it's in a controlled setting. But if you go to our website, theucbus.com, or if you follow us on Instagram at theucbus, we are updating. So as we come out with our next accelerator and come out with some of these other things, we're keeping everyone updated in that way. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I'm pretty excited about that.
Well, congratulations. This is really exciting news. And I'm sure you guys are having the nerves, but also this is going to be so good for your business and as it continues to grow.
Yeah, I cannot wait. And I'm really excited to see, you know, what happens in the future with what we're doing. I mean, our biggest goal is to transition into this place where not only are we doing this here in Columbus, which I'm happy that we started here, because it just so happens that our local government is on the same page where they're like, hey, we need to figure out how we can make smaller businesses more successful, or increase the success rate, increase the access to resources and funding. And so it's created an environment where we can thrive here, but we also want to be able to take this everywhere and spread this. And so not really recreating the wheel, but if there's other organizations that are in other locations, we can work with them to make sure that they're also creating culturally competent experiences for the whole community and not just one particular one.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah.
You definitely hit on my next question. That was that's great. You had a wonderful answer. It was basically, what is your company's goals? And so you did mention this right now. So then, into kind of integrate it still, what are some of your company values, and how are those values going to help you reach that goal?
So we really value, I mean, like, I know that I keep saying it, but it's super, super important to us because it's really the core of everything that we stand for. But it's creating that culturally competent experience, because that is super key. And we're all, like, you know, you and I are different. Even me and my business partners are different. So we all don't learn one way. You know, we all don't experience one way. So it's extremely important for us to not just have this cookie cutter accelerator. You go through this accelerator, it's tech, is this whole Silicon Valley, no shade to Silicon Valley.
Yeah, no shade, but, however.
but this whole experience, and we want to make sure that it's like, okay, that's good, but that doesn't work for everyone. You know, what about the people who are self-employed? What about the people who are hairstylists? You know, like, what about the people who have a mom and pop shop on the corner? So this concept is really great, because there's a lot of resources out there, but I see so many resources that are for textile businesses, or for bio businesses, or for businesses that are able to scale. What about those businesses that probably won't be a million-billion-dollar business, but they are able to influence the community? They're able to bring people into the community. They're able to, you know, on a very, very local level, help to influence change. That is very key. So it's not just about these businesses that can scale to these billion-dollar companies. It's also about the mom-and-pop shop that's rallying for people to vote, you know, like, just something as simple as that is just, it shows the correlation of the success rate of the businesses to the impact that it has on the community. So just to tie that all the way back, that's why the value, the core value for us is to create something that's culturally competent, because we need that experience, we need that success rate, we need to be impactful in that area. Mm-hmm. So I know that was a mouthful.
No, it answered the question fully. And inclusivity, especially in this political unrest, you talked about how important it is to vote. Absolutely. So we're very divided as a country, and not to get very political, however, you're making a great point of how including people, connecting people, is going to help us succeed. The economy is a little bit tricky right now with businesses being closed down. So it's more important than ever to help those startups and entrepreneurs that are getting things started. So
yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is. And it's funny that you say that, like, not to get real political, but so right now, it's actually, I ended up going back to school. So I'm in law school right now, because I know that this is really important. I'm going to be a civil attorney because there is a political side to business, and it's really important. In a lot of people, a lot of the businesses, I don't want them to have to feel like they have to get involved with that. But I also know how important that side of it is to just the future of how our businesses are ran for all of us. So yeah. So I mean, they definitely correlate for sure. Mm-hmm.
So then my next question is, what advice do you have for business owners starting out, other than bringing, you know, coming to you for all this research, education? Do you have any other recommendations on how they can build their business?
I think the biggest thing that I would say is don't be afraid to ask questions. You know, don't be afraid to not know, because a lot of people don't know. And I think that when we assume that we know everything, then we limit ourselves. And so asking the questions and then figure out what are the right questions to ask. So I want people to be able to look for that. The more that you look for that, the more that you Google, the more that you talk, network, ask questions, like, just don't be afraid. What's the worst that can happen? You know, and you might be able to run into someone who has access, and maybe they don't have the answer, but they know someone who has the answer. And so I think that that is the biggest advice, because there's so many different things that you can tell someone who's starting off a business. Like, like, there's so much advice. But I think the biggest thing that I would say is to just ask questions. And make sure that you're mindful about asking the right questions. And if you don't know the right question, then that is the question.
Well, those were all the questions I had. You had wonderful answers to all of them. And I feel like I definitely learned a lot more about Urban Accelerator X, and I hope listeners did as well. Do you have any final thoughts before we part, or any resources you recommend people look, like your website or anything else?
Yeah, for sure. So first, you can go to our website. So it's the UC Bus. So the letter U, then C, and then bus. So the UCBus.com. It's also that on our social media network. So on Instagram, you can find us on LinkedIn at Urban Accelerator X. And then on Facebook, you can like our page at Urban Accelerator X. I don't know. Okay, wait. So I thought about this. I was like, wait. What is the takeaway that I want to take away with? But I think the biggest thing that I will say for people who are watching this, because, you know, you might have some people who are a part of a entrepreneur support organization. Then there might be people who are looking for support, who are actual entrepreneurs. And I think the biggest thing that we want people to take away is that our organization wants to connect with both. We want to continue to build the ecosystem, but it's really important for us to connect the entire ecosystem. And so when I look at it, I look at this circle and I feel like there's this small gap at the beginning between access for Black and Brown people, and then also small lifestyle businesses, which includes a lot of businesses that are owned by women. And so I feel like there's this small gap, and we want to fill that gap, and we want to continue to build that ecosystem out in all areas. And so the more that we can connect with not just entrepreneurs, but also the organizations that are supporting the entrepreneurs and making sure that, hey, sometimes, you know, you might, your organization might be limited on your experiences. So allow us to help partner with you, or even make that relationship to build out or make sure that you're servicing everyone that you possibly can. It's really about collaboration at the end of the day. The more that we all are working together, it will create a better system for all of us. And our economy is depending on our businesses to be successful. All of them, every last one of them. And so that's pretty much, I mean, that's the last thing that I really have to say. So I really, and also thank you. Thank you for your time and thank you for even finding interest in us because it means so much. We really take our work seriously. And we value what we do. So being able to talk about it on platforms like yours, it just means the world to us.
It means the world to us that you chose to come with us as well. So thank you so much for coming along on this journey. Thank you so much for taking the time for this interview. And we wish you all the best from Mug.News.
Thank you so much.